Students, myself Babida Mathew. Today I am going to discuss about the topic RH incompatibility. During pregnancy, the mother and the fetus have different RH protein factors. This condition is called RH incompatibility. Like our blood type, we inherit our RH factor type from our parents. Most people are RH positive, but some percentage of people are RH negative. RH factor does not directly affect the health. However, the RH factor becomes important during pregnancy. Rachis disease is a condition where antibodies in a pregnant woman's body destroy her baby's blood cells. It is also known as hemolytic disease of the fetus and newborn. If the mother is RH negative and her baby is RH positive during pregnancy, and especially during the labor and delivery, some of the fetus RH positive red cells may get into the mother's bloodstream. That's the time when the separation of placenta occurs. Before the separation of placenta, there is no exchange of transmission occur, but only after the separation of placenta there is some RH positive cells are entered to the mother's bloodstream if the mother is negative. Then sensitization, the process in which mother's body will try to fight them off. That when the RH positive enter to the mother's body, so either the mother's body will try to fight off them by producing the antibody against the RH positive. So that is sensitization. And potassium sensitization events of RH disease are mainly miscarriage. During miscarriage, termination of pregnancy, antepartum hemorrhage, and invasive prenatal testing such as amniocentesis, choanocentesis, that same there is a chance of pricking, and there is a transmission from the maternal fetal transmission. That from the fetus to the maternal transmission may occur. Then at the time of delivery, when the placenta separation, and also in the ectopic pregnancy, also separation from the vulva where it is located, that time also there is a chance of transfusion of fetal positive cells, RH positive cells, to the mother's RH negative antibody. So then that will become sensitizing the mother's body. So that is, these are the main events. This time there is a chance of sensitizing the events for the RH disease. So we can see from this pictorial presentation, when the mother is RH negative and the father is positive and conceive a child. When RH negative, when the mother, and RH positive baby, because father is RH positive. Then cells from the RH positive fetus enter to the bloodstream. We already explained which are the time when it can be entered, when the placenta separation, miscarriage, ectopic pregnancy, we already explained. So after the separation of placenta, these positive RH cells are entered to the woman's bloodstream. So that same what will happen, the woman's bloodstream sensitized antibodies. So mother's bloodstream becomes sensitized antibodies that forms to fight against the RH positive cells. So they already ready for the fighting. Then what will happen next pregnancy, if the baby is RH positive and the mother's maternal antibody attack the fetal red cells, then the destruction of red cells will occur. This is the RH disease. Next, pathophysiology, the progression of RH factor sensitization. An RH mother and RH baby blood mixes, you can see the mother is RH negative, baby RH positive. The blood mixes in the time of separation or any event. This can occur with the previous pregnancy. Means the first pregnancy after the separation of placenta, this will happen. That is the pregnancy or miscarriage or with the bleeding during the pregnancy. All these events, there is a chance of mixing of blood will happen. So what will happen next time, the mother's antibody form, already mother's antibody formed to fight against positive. Okay, then that recognizes the Rh protein as foreign are formed by the mother. There are not enough antibodies to cause significant harm to the baby's red blood cells. Then mother's antibody, next in second pregnancy, the mother's antibody enter the blood, baby's blood, and attack the large amount of antibodies enter the baby's blood, attack to the red blood cell and identify them or store it due to Rh protein. The immune system attacks and destroys the red cells. So the already there is a antibodies formed. This antibody will attack the red cell positive cells of the next second delivery. Usually this precious disease happens. So it will attack and destroy the red cells. You can see from this, it will destroy the red cells. This is the Rh positive cell, so it will destroy. Then pathogenesis of Rh isoimmunization, mother is negative, father is positive. Then if the fetus is negative, there is no problem. But baby is positive, then what will happen? Rh positive RBCs enter to the maternal circulation. Mother non-sensitive mother, primary immune response happen to her body. The fetus unaffected in the first pregnancy, but baby usually escape, mother gets sensitized. Then if the mother previously sensitized with the first, if the first baby is positive, what will happen? Mother previously sensitized, second immune response happen, increase isoantibody IgG, and it will enter to the fetus in the second pregnancy if the baby is positive, and hemolysis usually occur. Next we can see the causes: ectopic pregnancy, partial molar pregnancy, blighted ovum, antepartum bleeding, external abortion, placental transfusion, placenta previa, placental abruption, abdominal pelvic trauma, in utero fetal death, any invasive obstetrical procedures such as amniocentesis, lack of perinatal care, postpartum, that is Rh positive baby, then spontaneous abortion. So all these events, if happen, there is a chance of fetal maternal transmission and sensitization of the mother. So in all these events when happen, the fetal blood that is positive may enter to the maternal blood. Next we can see what are the symptoms. In Rh incompatibility can cause symptoms ranging from very mild to deadly. In this meters form, Rh incompatibility causes the destruction of red blood cells of fetus. There are no other effects. After birth, the infant may have yellowing of the skin, that is the jaundice. Jaundice is a yellowing of the skin, whites of the eyes. Then low muscle tone, that is hypotonia, lethargy, swelling or edema, that is hydropsphytalis. Then signs of fetal anemia, usually that we already told, that is the it will destroy the red blood cells. Okay, so what will happen then? There is a chance of anemia. So polycythemia, enlarged fetal heart, ascites and pericardial effusion, hyperdynamic fetal circulation, reduced fetal movements, and abnormal CTG. We already studied this with the reduced variability. Then diagnosis, that is first is the MCA Doppler. What is MCA Doppler? MCA Doppler means it is fetal middle cerebral arterial Doppler, that is MCA Doppler. Next is cell-free DNA. Then Clehaut test. Clehaut test means that is the size of the fetal maternal hemorrhage. How much fetal maternal hemorrhage is occur and it is mixed to the maternal blood is tested by the Clehaut test. Next is amniocentesis and Lilly graph. Lilly graph, you can see from this picture, it is denominated by hematocrit level below 30%. Or a single value of SON3 are indications for intrauterine transmission. That is an illegal. In thus, this graph illustrates an example of amniotic fluid spectrophotometric reading of 0.206, which when plotted at 35-week gestation, falls into zone 3, indicating severe hemolytic disc. That is the Lilly plot. Next is a direct Coombe test. We already studied about this. This is done for the diagnosis. Then screening test ABO and RHAB at first perimeter. This should be done. And at 28 weeks should also done. And postpartum bleeding, the antibiotic bleeding before giving any immunoglobulin, neonatal blood for ABO and RH should be done. Then golden standard tests are indirect Coombe test and direct Coombe test. So, indirect Coombe test mix RHD plus cells with the maternal serum. Then anti-RHD AB with adher. The RBCs when washed and suspected in Coombe serum. Then RBCs coated with AB will be aggregated. This is the indirect Coombe test. And direct Coombe test mix infants RBCs with the Coombe serum and maternal AB present if the cell agglutinate. And direct Coombe test, you can see from this PCR, this is the patient sample, this anti-IgG Coombe reagent. So this is, we can see the baby sample is positive for this. If like this shown, that is means this agglutination occur. So the baby sample is positive for the presence of mother's AB or surface of RBCs, erythroblastosis, fetal. So this will be the agglutination result, direct Coombe test. Next is ultrasonic parameters. Non-reliable parameters are plastidial thickness, umbilical vein diameter, hepatic size, splenic size, polyhydramnios, and visualization of walls of the fetal bowel from small amount of intra-abdominal pressure may be first sign of impending hydrops. So we can see the fetal bowels from small amount of intra-abdominal fluid. So that can be seen by the it is starting the hydrops. Next, US reliable for hydrops. This ascitic pleural effusion skin edema HEB is less than 70. Next, photo the complication may occur due to rachous disease. This is during pregnancy, there is a chance of anemia, hyperbilirubinemia and jaundice. Severe anemia with enlargement of the liver and spleen may occur. In hydrops fetal, we already explained, after birth, severe hyperbilirubinemia and jaundice may be occur. And her kernicterus is one of the complications. What are the management can be done? Anti-D immunoglobulin, fetal blood transfusion, and phototherapy can be. This fluorescent light used for the phototherapy can be done. Then routes of administration into umbilical vein at the point of cord excision. You can do the intrahepatic vein into peritoneal cavity into fetal heart, and transfusion through blood is can be done for the RHD negative, cross match with the maternal sample and densely packed, that is white cell depleted and eradicated, and screen for the infection during CMV. Next is prophylactic vaccination during pregnancy, also can be given after miscarriage or abortion, after prenatal tests such as amniocentesis, chorionic villi biopsy, and after injury to the abdomen during pregnancy. So already we discussed about some of the points for the prevention. We can see that is avoid transfusion of RH positive blood and prevent fetomaternal transit. Fetomaternal transit we already explained which are the occasions where the fetal maternal transmission usually occur, that is amniocentesis, abortion, delivery, all these things. So prevent fetal maternal transmission, that is the internal pedalic portion, that all the events where the fetal maternal transmission occur. Then what all the medicine can be, that is administered anti-D immunoglobulin, that is 300 international unit after delivery or following abortion, that is 50 international unit within 72 hours are given to prevent, that is RH isoimmunization. So that's all about the RH incompatibility. I think all of you are clearly understood. Thank you once again. Thank you.